This is GOM TV. In the bottom left,
SK Telecom T1 Ray.
That's right. A lot of people here today.
Yeah, it's really surprising considering due to the delay, people were willing to wait it out. Pretty awesome. Yeah.
Well, if you won't wait to see these players, who are you?
In the upper right, in the yellow.
So dear.
All right. So, here we are. Do you think Deer wins this game and brings it to game five?
You know, I don't know what to expect with this whole series. Every single game is not looking the way I had thought. Endless GSL, that sounds like a good idea to me.
GSL will never end.
It will never
die. There will never be a final episode. The world will end before GSL.
They're eventually just going to have to reanimate us, bring us back from the dead. The zombie Archon.
You know what would be so funny?
What?
By the time that we actually die, the amount of GOM casting we would have done, they could actually just, like, make soundboards and then just, like, take our skin and put it
for
on those,
me especially,
on the Chuck E. Cheese robots. And it's, like, it's, you know, with, like, the weird blinks and the sudden movements and,
the,
like, I've got a banjo for some reason.
The scary Berenstain Bear eyes from Disneyland.
Yes, and the sickest soundboards.
I'm sure you
beautiful
could basically
Funko, they're, like, Fungals aren't even in StarCraft 4. What is going on here?
Yeah, man, you can easily just make a soundboard of all the stuff I say for intros and outros, and there you go.
I think we would be amazing Chuck E. Cheese robots.
I think we'd be pretty good.
We would scare more kids than the average, I would say. Than the average Chuck E. Cheese robot.
They did have a Chuck E. Cheese's in New Hampshire, right?
Yeah, Chuck E. Cheese's.
You know, it's so
everywhere.
Funny when you actually realize how freaky it is when you go there and they're like playing music and kids are eating pizza and it's just actually like something out of a bad dream. You know what I mean? When you see all those,
yeah, I know,
I don't know
exactly
if our whole
what
audience
mean,
is a Chuck E. Cheese's is, but
I know exactly
see those
what you
people
mean,
dressed up in those robot outfits. Did just spot that Nexus there warping in.
It's kind of a sneaky Nexus there.
Yep.
But no, I'm with you on that, Tasis. But you know what really gets me upset? They won't let you in there if you don't have a kid.
I just want some pizza and I want
to play
that Ninja
the
Turtles
Simpsons game.
Oh, the Simpsons game.
I just want to hit things with a vacuum cleaner with Marge, you know?
Yeah. But, I think Marge was actually the best in that game, by the way.
That was my opinion as well.
I think so. Was that a four-player or a five-player game?
It was four, I believe.
What was the one that was five or six players? Is that the X-Men arcade game?
I think you made that up.
No, I think I'm right. Or maybe it was,
it
like
was the ball pit, Tasis.
Sunset
the ball
Riders.
Pit was a five- to seven-player game.
How gross are ball pits, actually? How many germs are actually in those?
I actually go in ball pits again because of my baby. She loves ball pits.
Oh, I'm sure. But I'm just wondering how many kids actually have, like, gotten germs
I get
on the
sick
balls.
Way more often nowadays.
So
I shouldn't put the balls in my mouth, I know.
So we got two extra gates here for Deer inside the main. Rain is getting his Nexus
very
up and running.
Slow Nexus comparatively.
Yeah.
So, well, Rain is grabbing a really quick robo here. So I'm kind of interested in what he wants to do. And the robo is like basically just as quick for Deer.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I do hope this goes to game five.
I do too. I think it will, to be honest. I just look at these two build orders, and overall, I give the upper hand to Deer. I mean, he can't really be killed. His Nexus is way quicker. His robo is similar timing.
He's got an edge in every possible way, but don't forget, I mean, how many bad engagements have we had from both these guys? This game could turn upside down very quickly.
Yeah.
Now, Deer is warping in a few more units over here just outside. Now, did he spot them warping in, or did he just see them idle there? Because he doesn't see the pylon.
Oh, I think he saw them warping in, I'm pretty sure.
Okay.
Now, this is a little bit annoying. How far is the Nexus? It's pretty close to finishing, right?
Yeah, it's very close.
It's right there. So he's just got to be careful. He's got to try to make them waste a few shots. And next scan goes up, bam, saves it, no problem.
Now he's warping in some more Stalkers. He could keep warping in units. He's not even going to do the probe transfer actually yet.
Yeah, he's
just
actually
because he wants to try to actually take this Nexus out and bring this to game number five here.
Deer's got to be a little bit careful here, though. With four sentries, things like that can happen. And that could have been a little
bit
worse.
I'm surprised
even.
He engaged again with the Nexus Cannon still
up.
I'm like okay with it because he realizes that Rain doesn't have a ton of units right now, but just the fact that he warped in more units before going up and didn't just wait outside and then go up, that's an improvement upon last game.
All right, so he's got a lot of Stalkers. He's going to keep warping more and more in here. A lot of this, if he does decide to engage, will come down to how good is Rain with those Force Fields. Remember, he already spent three.
Well, here we go. One Force Field does go down. That Immortal really being worth a lot. I don't think that this is really breakable, which is an issue.
Yeah, I think he's got to stop. I think you're absolutely right.
Because right now it's 25 probes to 36. That is a gigantic difference in Rain's favor. You know, Deer did get such a quick Nexus up, but he's been skimping on probes so heavily. He's been just focusing on making a lot of Stalkers. And the thing is, when it's just Stalkers, I love that Rain has warped in some more sentries because he can just abuse Force Field.
He can just box him in.
What are you
going to
do with
up.
Just Stalkers? They don't have Blink. There's nothing that crushes Force Fields.
And Stalkers are really like the most brittle Protoss unit besides a Sentry or something.
Yeah.
But you need to have something else to take the damage, or the Stalkers have to be so overwhelmingly large in numbers that their range damage just does eliminates everything quickly. So, yeah, I mean, if you could Force Fields and you get him in a bad position, you are going to win that fight.
He can't go up the ramp again. And now he's got all these Stalkers that don't have Blink. What does he do with these? What is the game plan from here, I wonder?
Yeah, I'm curious. I don't actually know. We'll have to see.
Well, right now, Rain is grabbing his own Twilight. And, you know, he's got a very nice army against what he's facing. We do have Deer getting into some Immortal production, at least. Immortal. I think it's the best unit in PvP Tasteless.
It's actually my favorite unit to this day, the Immortal.
It's been
it's just so
my
cool,
favorite unit.
Like the way it works, and it's just one of the funner units in the game.
Yeah, I have most funnest time with it. It's most funnest time with that unit. It's really great.
So we got a plus one attack coming here, and we're gonna have Archon Zealot here from Rain, which makes sense. It's pretty consistent with what he's been doing throughout the series.
Well, it's such a solid unit composition, right? You know, he's already got, look at this, five sentries. He's already got a couple of Immortals out. If he just goes charge Archon and keeps on pushing out Immortals as much as possible, his army is not going to be defeated. Whereas Deer is going for Colossus tech, which I actually think is probably the right choice since he has so many Stalkers already.
Yeah.
He doesn't really have to worry about anything like Void Rays or even Tempest. So what he really needs to worry about is just the very normal composition that Rain is making at the moment.
And Deer's actually retreated and just backed up. He's going to turtle for the time being. He has to wait for at least I'd say about two Colossi before he can actually move out and try to do anything. One problem is going to be the third is a little bit tricky to take on this map for any race, really.
Yeah.
And, if he tries to get that that third and his army's out there in between the second and the third, and the Zealot Archons get a good surround, the Colossus is not going to be useful. And this is a map that's really got no obstructions beyond that one little square in the middle. You can get a really nice surround. You can really flank him hard.
I have to agree with you there, Tasis. Like, literally in this situation, and again, Deer is a bit behind, so I like going Colossus because you don't want to go for that same unit set. I'm a huge anti-fan of going for the same units as your opponent when you're behind.
Well, it doesn't make any sense because it becomes a math problem where you always have the smaller number.
But yeah, as long as Rain flies a Warp Prism towards the main and then just sits with Charge Law Archon Immortal below both the ramps of the natural and third, Colossus can't come out. It just cannot come out. You have an insane concave. You have a good unit set. And they have to watch out for warping into the main.
This might actually just be a very straightforward macro win here from Rain. Because Deer's a smart guy. He probably knows, I can't really get out of my base, you know?
He literally can't come out. And it's not like this is some wonky unit set that got a quick contain.
He is going to go out. Nope, he's going to turn around again. Okay. Mm. I was going to say, like you were saying, I'd be so surprised if he actually came out.
I think his plan here is to just get, three Colossus with range and then walk out and just kite with Colossus as much as he possibly can.
Well, if it's Stalker Colossus, he can kite with everything, so.
Yeah. And what he's going to really want to try to dodge is getting a bad Time Warp from Rain. Because if Rain throws out a good Time Warp while he's trying to kite, that's one of the reasons why Colossus tech is not as strong as it was.
We have Deer poking out here. So the Warp Prism's now going to go inside the main here. And looks like he'll get the Zealots out, but does not end up getting the War Prism, unfortunately, for Deer, that is.
Now, Rain is actually playing just I think Rain's going to run from this. He doesn't want to fight this right this second because he's realized that, in fact, Deer hasn't taken a third base, and he's taking up to Tempest right now. So if he can just, like, dodge this fight until he has a couple Tempests out,
yeah,
it's going to go grossly into his favor, whereas right now it could be close with nice kiting.
Oh, my God. They're actually going around each other.
Oh, boy. We're going to have a base trade?
Yeah. Okay, this is weird. Oh, but that does trigger Deer to turn around.
Okay, so Deer is coming up. Now, the Mothership Core, where is
where
that?
Where is it? It's there down there, it so okay. He can actually do a recall.
Yeah, he can actually throw down a Time Warp if he likes.
He might go for the Nexus, actually.
Yeah. This is a really great move. He can lose even a couple units here, and bam, down
that's
it goes.
So nicely done. That is so good.
That was a very quick warp home as well right after.
Absolutely beautiful.
And look at this. He's going to have two Tempests out by the time this army gets down here.
Yep.
And the amount that Tempest beat Colossus is pretty scary.
What with their inability to attack air and all, the Colossus is just no match for that Flying Tempest.
It's true.
It's true. You can't deny it.
Yeah.
Try it out. Go to the map or make your own map. See if we're right. Now, the angling here is actually going to be good for Deer, but I think the sheer amount of numbers, we'll see, though. It should favor Rain. The engagement has happened.
Well, this is not looking good for Deer Tasteless. I think we have our first finalist.
Yeah, it's going to be Rain. Rain actually running over Deer right now. Deer with his tail between his legs headed back home on one Nexus right now. The second Nexus he's making is the one that's going to be remade in his expansion.
And that is...
That's it.
That's that, man. He hasn't typed in GG yet.
There it is, GG. Deer defeated as Rain goes on into the finals despite a very bumpy game number one.
You know what? He outplayed Deer pretty significantly there. And I have to wonder, because I feel like both these guys are just tip-top tier. They both really know what they're doing. But I look at the teams that they're on, and if the best Protoss you have is Trap to play against, and then your opponent has a team full of Protosses like Parting, and other very strong Protosses as well. I feel like Rain has better practice partners for this.
He has
maybe a little bit more experience as well. And Rain is the guy who revolutionized and figured out Wings of Liberty PvP. And I feel like I'm seeing some really significant patterns from him that I'm not quite seeing from other players yet. Where I'm like, Rain knows exactly what he wants to do here, like 100%.
He's really refined. He's really clean. Mm-hmm. And he completely outclassed Deer. So that's going to be it for Deer for this year.
Yeah. Sorry, Deer.
So give Rain a big
time
cheer.
Time to go practice.
Yeah. So Rain is either going to be against a Terran or a Zerg here, either Sulky or Morrow.
And look at that. He's secured at least 35 grand this year in prize money. That's pretty sick.
That's a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't realize it's been that long since his last finals, actually. Almost 120 days.
That one against Maru. Time flies. That's like 4 months.
Yeah.
Wow.
How about that?
All right.
All right. We're going to be having an interview here with Rain to see what his thoughts are now that he is in the finals of the Hot 6 Cup, the final.
Dude, we could have Rain-Maru rematch.
We
That's
could.
A possibility.
저희가 좋아하는
프로토스를 소환했었거든요.
저희가 지금 여기다 수정탑을 하나 꽂았더니
수정탑이 있고요. 철망이도 위에 떠 있습니다.
위에 지금 아 있습니다. 자 정윤종 선수 일단 축하드립니다.
아 네 감사합니다.
오늘 경기 스스로 만족을.
Congrats, just thanks. Are you satisfied with your performance?
너무 변수가 많아서 네 그렇게 경기 내용은 마음에 들지 않는데 그래도 결과가 좋기 때문에 만족은 해요.
아 오늘 경기 내용이 마음에 안 드세요?
I'm not really satisfied with my performance today. Especially game number one. But the results were good, so I'll just let it. So brave.
Oh, 네, 제가 못하고 있을 때 정준이가 굉장히 잘 나가더라고요.
네. 네
그래서 네, 잘한 선수인 것은 인정하되 그래도 코스에는 별로 늘.
When I was not doing well, Deer performed really well and won a lot of tournaments. So I felt a lot of pressure coming into this match.
하지만
But I was confident in myself because of my skills improving.
단단하고 초록성 같은 이런 느낌이다라고 설명을 해주셨는데 이런 게 좀 도움이 되었을까요?
네 우선 제 이미지가 좀 네, 단단한 이미지잖아요.
예.
네, 그래서 네, 그걸 네, 역으로 이용도 할 수 있고 그래서 그런 이미지는 굉장히 좋은 것 같아요.
네, 제가 그랬어요. 자 황영재 선수 궁금한 네. 거 있으신가요?
I'm very known for my defensive play. 그 so
최근에 좀 활동이 뜸하다가
my opponents know that I'm going to play a long game.
그 스타일이 많이 바뀌었다는 느낌을 좀 받았거든요.
So I use that to my advantage. 그 in my future matches.
플레이의 성향이 좀 바뀔 수 있도록 도움을 주는 그 주변 그 인물이 있다면 네, 조금 이 자리를 빌어서 한번 좀 설명해 주시면 감사하겠습니다.
아, 사실 그냥 저희 팀에 네, 도우 형도 있고 네, 이사기도 있고 정주도 있어서 많이 배우긴 하는데
Any shoutouts to your fans? Or people who help you prepare?
네. 네
저만 저 제 생각에 좀 깨달은
게 많아가지고 And 네, some of his other teammates, they helped him or they helped me prepare
네,
for 아, the PvP today. And I learned a lot from them.
오셨군요.
네, 내공이 네. 좀 네, 쌓였어요.
그렇습니다. 제가 머리 스스로인데 제 내공이 좀 쌓였습니다.
이 정도면 이미 끝난 거예요.
그렇습니다.
네, 더 이상 없습니다.
자, 요즘에 이제 하는 간에 좀 말이 많습니다. 프로토스가 너무 강하다. 그런 평도 좀 있고 이번에 결승 대진도 그런 거 보니까 프로토스 대 비프로토스가 됐어요. 자, 이제 이어지는 경기에서 조성조 선수 대 김민철 선수의 경기가 준비되어 있습니다.
So who do you want to face in the finals?
어떤 선수가 결승에 올라올 것 같으며 바람으로는 어떤 선수가 올라왔으면 좋겠는지.
우선 김민철 선수가 올라올 것 같아요.
아 올라올 것 같아요.
네. 네. 올라왔으면
I'm pretty sure Silky is going to win against Mario.
선수는 형준은 네. 개인적으로 제가 그 결승전에서 졌는데 그래서 뭐 그래도 해외 대회 예선에서 제가 이겼거든요.
네, 네. 아 이미 복수를 했어요.
네, 복수를 했는데 아직 김민철 선수는 복수를 못 했어요. 네. 3대 0으로 8강에서
Even though I lost 네. to Mario in the recent finals. I was able to defeat him in foreign tournaments.
여러 가지 뭐 스토리상으로도
And I lost to Silky recently, but I haven't got my revenge yet. So yeah, hopefully he comes up to the finals so I can get my revenge.
뽀송뽀송한 표정은 지금 눈빛이 전혀 안 들렸으니까. 네, 알겠습니다. 아 정윤종 선수 결승전에서 많이들 응원을 하실 겁니다. 아 결승전 이제 10월 8일 우리 일요일 날 오후 5시에 진행이 되는데 우리 팬 여러분들께 한 말씀 부탁드리겠습니다.
Any final comments to your fans?
오랜만에 결승 진출했는데 제 스스로도 제가 좀 예전과는 다른 모습이라고 생각해요.
네.
그러니까 이번에 진짜 기대 많이 해주셨으면 좋겠어요.
네,
It's my first time in a long time being in the finals.
직접 오셔서
And even though I wasn't performing well recently, I got a lot better. So please look forward to the great matches that I'm going to bring in the finals.
뜨거운 경기 부탁드리겠습니다.
네, 감사합니다.
네. 자, 이렇게 해서 정윤정 선수의 자연의 결승 진출자
Hi, Artosis.
Hey, Tasteless.
He's pretty confident.
He should be.
He should be.
He's the greatest Protoss of all time.
Especially after that last series. A bumpy game number one, and still then three
kinda,
wins in a row.
Yeah, kind of crushing, really.
Yeah.
It's kind of, I feel like neither of them
I
really did
the
their best.
I thought the match was going to be overall closer than that, but I don't know. Well, we're going to go to our next best of five to see who's going to be our other finalist after this short break, so stay tuned.